Yeah, so I'm like sounding good right now, I guess. So I think we can do it. I cannot like use it even. So I think we can ask Killer. He can moderate it somehow. No, he can't actually. Wait, I'll try to do something with twitch.tv/RL. He should be here. Okay. What the fuck is wrong with this? I have this team beta and it's fucking me up. I don't know. One for the record books. Yeah. Do it like not decided versus diamond as it's written. Yeah. It's working. Yeah. Not. Which team is blue? Guacamole. No, but he like had to make a server, no? Diamond Dust is blue. Yeah.
Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to the 19th edition of our Rocket League India community scrims. Sorry about the delay. I wasn't too sure if our stream was up, so I was just clarifying that to the viewers. Yeah, today we have two matches. Not Decided versus Diamond Dust, and match two being Blackout versus Sol Mabia. And joining me is our fellow admin and tournament manager, Nish Chahar. Nish, say hi to the stream.
Yeah. Hey guys, so what's up? So we're starting with a scrim soon. I hope you guys will stay here and we'll start soon. We're getting the teams ready, we're getting them into the lobby. Ace is helping us today. He's moderating the lobbies and stuff. So hope we'll start soon.
Yeah, so Not is actually a new team, so I sort of helped them up. And Diamond Dust is going to be Popo. Okay, we are actually going to start our game. So, yeah. So Diamond Dust is actually a makeshift team for now. It's Krimicon, Zac Destructo and Popo versus Not Decided, who's Piper, Extreme and Akwak. So
I've seen them play, like Diamond Dust, I've seen them play, but Popo was not there before. And that can be a, like, I don't know how it'll go, like, because Popo is probably a, Popo is definitely a high ranked player, and these days are like gold or something. I'm not sure about that, but still, looks like Popo is taking it away, and he's taking a starter. Is that in? No. Yeah.
Extreme moving it to the side, giving possession back to Destructo, centering it for his team. Akwok with the nice clear. Popo taking his time to clear it away.
Yeah, it's like Popo is like really dominant from the blue side. He's the one who's taking away the ball all the time.
Oh, Orange with an opportunity. All of them in the same corner though. Someone's rotating back. Piper with a shot. No, misses. Aqua trying to center it for his team again. Crimson with the possession. Passing it to Popo. Popo with a nice 50-50.
And it's coming back to Zach. Zach send it towards the corner and there's nobody to like... Oh, it might be a goal. No, he's always there, so...
Aquak giving away possession back to Popo, who comfortably clears it. He's trying to center it for his team. Is there anyone to follow? Destructor again centering it. Crimsicon, can he get it? I might have just butchered his name over there. But...
yeah, so like, as we can see, like, it's pretty equal right now. Both teams are working to try, like, trying really hard to get a goal, but they are like not able to get one yet. So Orinsen is a corner, but there's Zek is there. Okwok, I don't know what his name is. Okwok is like trying to get a center, but Popo is there to clear it out. And Popo now may have an opportunity. He's like trying to center it for his teammate. No, he's going for a solo play there, and back into the corner. Zach with the shot, and oh, that's just wide. Popo again trying to center the ball. Aquak with the clear. And Aquak is cornering the ball in the center, and that's clear from Popo again.
Popo with an opportunity. A double touch, maybe?
Yeah, can get a double touch. No, Zach missed it as well. Oh, that was a demo in the air by Crimson. He missed it. Popo trying to get it back. Zach is there to center the ball. And Crimson is a shot opportunity, but he missed it. Extreme, is that right?
Yeah, it's extreme. Let's just call him extreme for now.
Yeah. Aqua centering the ball right here, but Zach is there to clear it out. Not a really good clear though. He's trying to get it center again, but Extreme comes in and he takes it to the wall. He's going for a shot and he couldn't get it. Crimson gets the ball and he's trying to pick out two players but misses. And Aquak with a shot, but Popo saved it. And now the ball is in the corner of the blues. Popo picked out Pied Piper and he's going for the center.
Oh, and that's center, solo player though.
Went for a shot, but he missed. Yeah. He's a solo player, like, he'll go for those plays, he'll make it damn happen, and he gets you, like, with those solo plays.
Yeah. So, Popo trying to center it for his team again.
Yeah.
Zach trying to figure out when to approach the ball, giving time for Popo to come in. Popo trying to dribble it past one. Centering for his team, no, goes Let's for the solo player.
The extreme is to save it. And the ball is again in the blue half. And Pied Piper pushed it center. I don't know if he's getting past or not. No. And Popo clears again. We're seeing Popo a lot, like on the defensive, offensive side. So Popo making a shot here. No, it's so wide. And Extreme just clears it in the corner of the blue, centering it. No, he missed. And Popo is there again to clear it. Popo with the shot towards the goal. That Zach was there to save it. Now the orange team is trying really hard to like keep the ball in the blue side, but they're missing somehow on the goals opportunity. So, and Popo again with a solo play and denied by Piper. Zach is there, right, and he demos Extreme in like air and Popo, no. So first match and the overtime is there.
Yeah, it's Destructo versus Aquak. Crimson following it up. Nice 50-50 in the middle. Followed up by Crimson.
Yeah.
Both of them went for the corner boost. Pied Piper just couldn't get back into time.
Yeah. And if Crimson wouldn't followed him, like he wouldn't got that shot as well.
Yeah.
So that was some like a weird decision, I would say, from Crimson. Like just go for it instead of the boost like normally we play go for. So yeah, first game to Diamond Dust, and it's a best of five if I'm not wrong. So we'll have best of five from this and the other one as well. So game two right now.
Yep.
So we see right here on the score screen that even though Purple didn't score, he still has the highest points because he got so many clears and shots in the goal, but he was still unable to like convert them into a goal. But never mind, his team won anyway. So,
yeah, Pytnipa still sort of trying to find his place and not decided. Not really anything in the board. Yeah. 0 goals, 0 assists, 0 saves. But yeah, I think being a new team, they are still trying to figure it out. They are roughly plat level, if I am sure. Like, yeah. I think they just made a team yesterday and they want to try themselves out in the scrims.
So, yeah, it'll take time to like have the chemistry between players when you have the team and all. I think a lot. So, like, that's how you get better chemistry and everything with the team. It's not that, like, really easy to get that stuff.
Yeah, it will take a few more tries at least to get them into the level that they want to be. I'm still waiting on one player. I don't think he loaded in. Okay, Popo is now loaded in.
Okay.
So, the kickoff would be Popo versus Pytnipa. Okay, Popo reaching to the ball faster, but Pytnipa with a slow kickoff manages to win it. Awkwok centering it, no misses. Can anyone follow that up? Destructor pushing it to the side. He has some space here. Awkwok going back to goal, staying in goal. Pytnipa moving it to the side. Popo. Missed it. Awkwok searching for his teammate, misses. Crimson just waiting, misses the ball.
Right there, like, Zach couldn't clear it. That was a really bad clear from Zach. And he's trying his best to, like, get the ball out of the blue half. And Popo does it. He gets into the corner, but Awkwok is there to, like, get it there. But, again, Popo is again there to, like, make it into the center and all. Crimson with the center, but nobody was there to, like, make a goal opportunity out of it. Popo trying a solo play, and he gets it.
An awkward sort of angle shot. He just manages to get under the ball enough to give it the height to beat the remaining defender.
Yeah, and Echo was just not ready for this because Popo turned so like fast and he was not prepared at all for that shot to come. And we see Pytnipa winning the kickoff here and Zach sends it back again to the orange half, but Echo is there to clear the ball right into the goal and it's a goal. That was so quick. That was so quick.
A nice power
like,
clear.
Awkwok just comes out. Yeah.
Right.
And that turned into a goal like directly.
Yeah.
No one expected that shot. Okay, that was some kind of a neutral kickoff. And there comes Popo back again. Really off goal. Zach misses the ball. Popo gets it, fakes out his own teammate and Pytnipa with a corner and Zach is there to like get it out. Popo tries to get a touch on the ball but fails and they are bumping each other. Teams, the blue team is bumping each other. They all want to get closer to that ball and they all want that goal on in their name. And Popo is trying really hard. Like, we are seeing a lot of solo plays from him and he's that kind of a player. Like, who can carry his whole team. And Popo again with a clear, but Extreme is there, he misses. Awkwok is there, he also couldn't clear it. And now the ball is a corner, just sitting there.
Yeah, Zach, I think Crimson is actually AFK, might have crashed.
Yeah.
Awkwok with an opportunity now. And make use of the time when you have it.
Yeah, Crimson left the match. I think he's having some technical issues.
Hopefully he'll get back into the game quickly, but we are continuing the game since 2 minutes are down.
Yeah, so Extreme, there's no one to like contest for that kickoff with Extreme. And Pytnipa shoots back in the corner of the blue. Popo is there, like, but it was almost goal. Popo still clearing it out, but there's three players and only two from blue. And Pytnipa trying to center it. He takes a shot as well but couldn't get it. Extreme and Awkwok and no missing. Pytnipa gets it back again in the blue. Popo tries to get it out but centers back. Extreme is there to again center the ball. Aqua takes a shot, but Popo is there.
I wonder if his teammate will be able to join. Oh, a nice dribble flick.
Yeah, from Popo, but like, that was so unfortunate, that shot missed. It just stayed like on the goal line, and that's a goal.
And overcome it from Popo in the goal over there. Pied Piper just with a strong 50-50 into a pinch. So yeah, calculated, I'd say.
Yeah, that was such a like, he Popo even wrote it like face palm. That was really bad. Right. He might have like really tilted after that.
Yeah, they are still one member down, so there would be more reason to tilt.
Yeah. And that was such a nice flick and it didn't went in, so that's like really, really, really triggering. Popo trying to get a shot, but Extreme is there to clear it out. Popo catching the ball again and going with a flick, but Pied Piper is there. So it's like basically 1v3 kind of scene right now, because Zach is staying in the back and Popo with a goal. That was a nice setup, I would say, but Zach, like, right there he went for it and Pied Piper have to save the ball and it just bounced off him and Popo has the opportunity to score.
Destructor moving it to the side. I don't know, are they still missing their player? Like, they're not, he's not able to come into game.
Yeah, I think I should ask the moderator, like, if he can work it out.
Yeah, let me just, yeah. I'll just continue casting when you try to do that. Okay, Aquak moving down to the center. Popo and Zach both on the same side. Little bit awkward since they're still missing the third player, but Popo manages to make that touch. Moving to the side, playing the defense. Bumps Zach in the process. Going for boost. Realizes that a wall play is a bit dangerous there. Extreme staying back. Oh my god.
Shot on the goal and Zach was unable to save it. That's a really easy save through, but I think he didn't expect the ball to come into his direction that quick. And he just like beamed it right away. And
indeed,
that's a goal for Roaring.
Popo versus Piper. Piper with a center kickoff, but Popo staggers his kickoff. So it ends up winning. Okay, close one.
That was really close, yeah. That was a really good save from Aquak and he sends the ball to the blue half. Zach is there. He's trying his best, but Popo comes in and he gets the ball to the midfield, but they're sending it back to the center again and again. It's
nice.
Hard to play, like, that was a really bad shot from Extreme. And they're pressuring the blue team because they're three and they're only two. And the game is over. So yeah, I would say this score we see right here is only because of the thing that they're missing a player, because they have more opportunities to score.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
I'm still trying to figure it out with the moderator why he's not back yet.
I have a bad feeling that our moderator might have taken a small break. So
yeah, that could. That
Ayush is joining.
Okay. Cool. Let's wait till then.
Let me just edit to this thing. So, not decided taking this game.
Yeah, so I hope we get like all the five games. So it'll be more fun because like now Diamond Dust has won one and not decided has won one. So we move on to game three. A team still has to win three games to continue on. So let's see. Crimson is back. He joined the match. I can see him. So I think we can get ready.
Yep, Crimson is back into the lobby and I'm hoping that this will be a closer match, probably going the way the first game did, but I'm not counting out not decided completely yet.
Yeah.
Popo again with the late start, probably his internet just loading in. Uh, Okay, Popo's back. Comes in. Okay, Destructo versus Extreme. Destructo winning the kickoff. Crimson following it up. Quick follow. Awkwok taking his time. Destructo waiting to clear the ball. No, Crimson taking it instead. Popo following it up. Crimson with a nice touch to beat one person. Popo with some time. He's trying to center first team. Going to flick it up. A nice center for Destructo who follows it up. Popo taking his time. He actually beat three players in that process to make that play happen, and Destructo just had to tap it in. Okay, we lost Popo as well.
Yeah, and I also just joined in the lobby. Somehow I was kicked out of it, so I just joined in.
Yeah, Popo's back.
The Pied Piper, Zach trying to get it on the other half, but unable to do it. Crimson whipping it. And like orange team now is pressuring the blue half. But Popo gets on the orange half and Pied Piper is there to peel back again. And Popo left the match again.
I have a bad feeling he's having some, micro lag that he's trying to fix. So
yeah, I think so. So Extreme with a shot, but it's really wide. Aqua with a shot, but misses. And goal. Pied Piper. That was like actually they pressurized the whole blue team into like shots after shot after shot, and they were unable to save this last one.
Yeah, I noticed that Destructo is sort of weak in his rotation in defense. He overextends and he gave Awkwok that opportunity to center first team. Awkwok with a touch back into center. Destructo and Popo double committing, but Destructo going for it, trying to center first team. Popo with a nice
that
follow through.
That was a great pass and a great goal. That was really, really, I would say, really very thinking of Crimson to get a pass to Zach. Okay, he's back again. My bad. I thought it was Zach.
Yeah, Crimson
and Piper wins the kickoff. Zach is there to clear it out, but Piper bumps him in the process. Getting back to his half, Pied Piper takes the ball control, but Aqua is there to take it from him. He tries to Popo with a I don't know, was that a back pass?
Not really, he was. No, he was just it was just a misplay. Extreme taking his time, flicking it down center. Destructo with enough time moves it to the side. Aqua with a nice contest. Extreme, can he follow it up? No, Aqua moving it back to goal. Doesn't know what to do really now. Bit of a mess over there. Crimson passing it to Popo. Popo following it up. Aqua, can he make that save happen? He does. Oh, Extreme misjudged that bounce. Aqua bouncing it up, trying to center first team, misses. Popo moving to the side. Centers it instead for Orange. Which is close shot, nice save by Destructo. Piper moving to the side. Backward shot. Awkwok. Close one.
And Awkwok steps back. Like he's trying to get to the ball and he gets it, but Popo is there to again. And Popo misses out on it. Awkwok in the center. Popo clears it. And but Extreme is there to send it back onto the blue goal. And Extreme is trying to get to the ball and everyone misses out. Popo gets to it, Zach blocks a shot. And it's like this ball chasing right now. Everyone is like trying to get the ball in the other goal. So Popo takes the control of the ball, but Aquak is there to send it back. And Popo takes it out somehow. Zach going past two of the defenders. And he misplaces it again, and Popo is back there to get the thing. And Popo, the double deck, though. He tried to do a double deck, but was not able to do it. Zach back in the goal, Piper going for a shot, Zach clear it out, and it goes directly into the orange half.
Popo waiting for the bounce to happen on the corner, orange team. doesn't really know what to do with it, finds the ball awkwardly in the AHA, but Aquak has made the defensive rotation. Oops, bother them. Okay. Crimson moving to the side, Popo missing that clear. Aquak with a good center, searching for extreme. Let's see from Zach's perspective, that was a weird contest, but it sort of worked out. Popo leaving the game yet again. So it's Destructo versus Aquak. Blue wins it.
Aquak backed off and Popo's back in the game again, and we see Orange team trying to move its ball to the blue half here, and Aquak does it, but Popo is there to clear it out on the red, and he might have a shot of him, but no, he misses. Zach, that was a nice pop, and Pied Piper with trying to get the ball in the blue half, and still that phone goes to Popo. Popo tries to clear it, but instead just gives it more power to like go in his own goal.
Yeah, it sort of bounced off his back. He tried to angle shot it away from his goal post, but it just ended up going back into goal. Crimson winning that 50-50.
Extreme trying to dribble it out, but Popo was there to like send it back. And that's a shorter goal, but white, and that ends the game, and Diamond Dust are the winner. So we all know these points are not real. Like Purple left the game so many times, so he doesn't have that much point right now. But okay, so now we have 2-1, two Diamond Dust and one not decided. So we move into game 4 right now. And whoever wins this, like if Diamond Dust wins this, they'll win it. They'll win the best of 5 series. If not, then we go into the game 5.
Yeah. Just trying to reduce the volume of the in-game music. I'm a bit conflicted. Yeah. So we'll be moving into our 4th game. Popo's still having some issues with his net, so that's why. But still, despite that, Diamond Dust has managed to come out on top.
I think something's wrong with the server, because I just saw Extreme have a ping of 800 something for a while, and it came back to 48. So, it might be a server, I don't know.
It's possible.
Okay, so, we're going Urban Central for this thing. Next game in the year was Urban Central, and is Popo joined? Popo left again. And the two players missing from Diamond Dust side. The game will start. We have to get them in.
This is awkward.
Okay, Crimson is there. Crimson made it back. Yeah, he joined the match.
It's just Indian things, man.
Yeah. That's so bad. We should have some servers in India. That would like really, really help the game grow.
Yeah, so the entire blue team has loaded in within the first 20 seconds. I'm just going to assume that it's going to start fresh now. Piper with a contest. Crimson there to save it. Destructor going to follow it up. Getting bumped by Popo, who decides to follow the shot from Crimson. Oh no.
Orange team is pressurizing the blue team really now, but they get it somehow out of the half, and now the blue is on offensive side of it, and his Zach missing the ball. Crimson is there to clear it out, but Zach Aqua comes in and sends back to the center, and it's back at the orange half again. Popo with a nice shot, but the defender was there to block it off, and it's again in the blue half. Crimson trying to clear it, goes to Popo, and back into the blue half. Orange team is really trying to go into the 5 game now. Like, they know if they lose this, that will end the series. So they putting on really good offensive pressure on the blue half, but they're unable to get the goals through. And what a pinch from Pied Piper, and that goes directly into the goal. Like, nobody expected that thing. See, Pied Piper and XT. That's just insane.
127 kilometers per hour.
That is insane. Nobody was ready in the blue half to like stop that kind of a shot.
Oh, I gotta avoid Popo's camera because I'm getting the default camera glitch. Okok moving into the side, Popo interrupting. Extreme with some space, one to beat. Pied Piper searching for Pied Piper. Is he there? Yeah. He's following it up. Destructive clearing it away. Okok trying to center it first. He misses. Popo instead takes up possession. Ooh, loses the 50-50 to Pied Piper, who slots that in. What? Okay. I sort of messed up. Okay. So, Piper and Extreme both going for it. No, Piper slows down, follows up the win. Trying to center first team, but Popo moving it away. Extreme contested. They start clearing it to the center. Extreme touching it again. Popo, that's pretty dangerous.
Coming back.
Used a lot of boost in the process. Destructor clearing it away from his goal. Blue lacking the boost to now make the plays happen. Popo? Yeah.
Popo tries to do something with it, but unable to do anything. Extreme send it to the wall. Pied Piper is there, but it was a good 50-50 from Zach. And he gets the ball cornered and he's trying to center it now. Maybe pass it, but Popo comes in and hits it again, but Aqua was on the wall waiting for it and he clears it. And now he's looking for his teammate to make a passing play, but there's no one there. And that was like, that could have been a goal, but it was kind of wild from him. And like, Blue now charging through the orange team.
Yeah, that was a statistical blow up by Pied Piper there. Saved his teams, yeah, and gave his team some space.
Aquak with an awkward shot, and they're trying really hard to clear the ball, but the Blue is like maintaining pressure on them.
Yeah.
Orange team, yeah, Pied Piper makes it clear somehow, and he misses the ball when he gets down on the ground. Aquak tries to send it in the Blue, but sends it the other way across the goal. Popo trying to touch it, and no, that's a goal. Popo, he has gotten that wouldn't have been a goal, but he misses it and Pied Piper was there to score it.
Yeah, good follow through by Pied Piper.
Yeah.
I guess Popo still having an international.
Yeah. So Zach with a shot.
It's the backboard, but Popo was there to clear it away.
With the spider defense, and RL is faster said. So Crimson trying hard to get the ball out of the blue half.
Nice Popo contest back by Piper. Misses out on the center. Okok with the nice center, trying to center first teammate. Okok moving to the corner. Again, searching for his teammate, but that was a little bit too powerful. Popo clearing it down the center. Yeah. No one there to follow it, really.
Yeah. Popo trying to pressurize the orange team.
Okay. I think I DC'd. I DC'd for a second there.
Yeah, this server is like really bad. I'm like getting the constant disconnection symbol sometimes.
Okay.
So Popo making a play here and he tries to dribble it out and the player, orange team player, whips it. Totally.
We really need to watch it through Orange's perspective. Extreme like, just misjudges that and Okok was not there to see it elsewhere.
I think he thought it would be more of a powerful shot, but it was like such a soft shot. I think Popo went for a powerful one, but he could not get it and there where he like misjudges it and that goes in. Anyway, with that goal,
not decided wins. Yeah.
So the game going into game five right now. It's 2-2. They still don't want to play in Wasteland, even though it's standardized now. Let's see, can we have the new map, the Farmstead one?
Oh, did my game crash? Feels like it did.
No, it's still showing you in the lobby. Okay, so we're going to Farmstead for this game. Are you in the lobby?
No, I disconnected. Yeah. Give me a second, I'll try joining.
Yeah. Popo, I'm also waiting for Popo. Popo left the match.
Yeah.
Anyway, it's going to get started. Crimson going for the kickoff, nobody can contest him, and that's directly a kickoff goal. Right in the middle. I think Orange team had the advantage here. They could have gone for the kickoff, but they don't, and Crimson shooters directly into the goal.
Yeah, I'm back. Piper versus Crimson. Crimson winning the kickoff, moving to Extreme, but Extreme doesn't want to. He's leaving it for his team. Popo trying to center. Centers it to himself. Piper with some time.
With a clear.
Moving to the side, Awkwok searching for his teammate, Extreme leaving the ball to blue to clear. Nice contest by Piper. Extreme misses that ball completely. Awkwok calculates that touch away from Piper. Open now has some space.
Bumping Awkwok.
Yeah, sorry, my bad. Continue.
And the blue team is pressuring the orange right now, and orange is trying really hard to get the ball away from the side. And Piper going for the clear here, but he tries to make it across the goal somehow. And he's dribbling it, but that's a demo from Popo and Piper. And Extreme winning 50-50 with Popo. And the ball is back in the orange half. Piper with a really weak shot, and Popo comes in and shoots it. Directly the goal.
Yeah, Pied Piper couldn't do much over here. He centers it for Popo, who just slots it into the far corner.
Yeah. He was in such an angle, he couldn't get a good clear out of there.
So yeah.
He did what he can do, and then just centers the ball for Popo. Pied Piper and Popo going in the air. Pied Piper winning the 50-50. Ball goes into the corner, Zach is there, he'll try to clear it, and yeah, Piper send the ball back, but it's again in the blue half, Popo behind the ball, and that's a really, really nice shot from Popo. He waited for it, and just when like the ball was like below the crossbar, he went for that extra push directly.
Popo against Extreme. Popo going for the pinch. Extreme winning that kickoff. Crimson, can he follow it up? Misses. Popo also misjudges that. Extreme searching for his teammate, but Pied Piper is not able to follow it through. Destructor centering it for his team. Awkwok. Re-jumping misses it out of it completely. Extreme searching for Awkwok, who misses the center to Pied Piper. Extreme following down. Crimson is back in goal, comfortably waiting, and then cleared away.
That could have been a short opportunity for Extreme, but Zach was there to block it. And now it's I don't know what is happening. Popo trying to get it away from Blue Half, but White Leopard has a good 50-50 with him. That was kind of close. Popo now, no one's there, but he just whips it off by dribbling it. And White Piper with Crimson with a clear here. He centers it in the midfield. Popo going for it. White Piper catches it. Aqua with a corner. And Popo trying to get it, but
Orange has rotated too hard.
Yeah.
But Blue was not able to capitalize on it. Extreme tried to center, gave away possession to Blue. Crimson back in goal, waiting for the bounce. Moving to the side, getting boost in the process, misses the pinch. Awkwok misses the 50-50. Zach trying to follow it up. Popo misses the touch. Extreme with the shot opportunity. Crimson with the clutch 50-50. Piper moving to the side. Awkwok trying to center it first team. Extreme going to follow it up, but Popo fakes him. Interesting play. Popo searching for his teammate. Drift flick down the center, Crimson moving down the side. Awkwok, nice 50-50, winning it. The entire blue goal is empty, but Orange just cannot capitalize on it.
And whole Orange team was there, and still no one was able to capitalize on that thing. And they're still pressuring the blue half, but they know they have to score, otherwise they're gonna lose it. And Popo going for an aerial shot and just misses it on the cross. Orange trying really hard to clear this ball away, but Popo is keeping the ball in the Orange side, and he's going for a shot again. He misses it. Crimson putting it to the corner, centering it. He misses. Popo. He's going for a solo play again, probably go off the wall, but he gets a really weird 50-50.
That was a bit dangerous by Popo. He's trying to move it back so that he could get possession and boost.
Yeah.
Ended up misplaying it, but Blue is safe right now.
Right. I think Popo is playing more risky right now because they have the lead. So he's trying on more risky plays to get more goals. That's the only reason I think he went for that thing. Whoa. He went back and wanted to go for the boost.
Piper and Extreme both missing that shot. Awkwardly trying to center that. Extreme, Popo nice 50-50. Can there be a 0-second goal?
There it is.
You ask there for it and then you shall receive it.
And that looked really, really close. It was just almost on the ground.
And the best part about that shot was Awkwok went there, was not even able to get the tip of his car. He ended up doing a backward flip, and the ball had just enough height to get into the goal.
Yeah. So, as you said, you shall ask and we should receive it. At least they had a goal. And it was a nice series between the teams.
Yeah, it was relatively close, but I mean, I think that Diamond Dust was plagued with Popo just joining in and leaving with the micro lag issues. But yeah, in the end, Diamond Dust did prevail. And I guess we'll be moving to our next match, which would be Blackout versus Hold My Beer. So these are actually two established rosters, sort of, at least in the scrim scene. Blackout will be Alnicky, Dizzo, and Ergon. And All My Beer is Ebar. I think Killer Cupid is subbing in for them this time. And who's the third? Kerwin.
So Dizzo's new to Blackout. He's a part of Liquidy, but that disbanded a while ago. And same goes for Popo. He was also in the Liquidy. And after CC5, Dizzo was banned from playing it.
Okay.
So I don't know. I don't know. Might have been Dizzo's new team, because the last CC, CC6, Popo played in Blackout, if I remember correctly.
Yeah, so Popo has been, I don't know if it's official yet, but he has been kicked out of Blackout and they are trying out a third. So they have tried out Dizzo. They were scrimming against me yesterday, so they are relatively strong. Their rotation is really good, so that's something that I'm looking forward to watching in this game. But Holmer Beer has the clear mechanical skill advantage in Kerwin as a player. So it might be a really nice show.
Yeah, so I'm looking forward to this match because both the rosters are pretty strong.
Yep, indeed. Okay. I guess Ace might be waiting for me to leave the match.
Yeah. Okay, so I just got this. Star Melon is playing instead of Cupid.
Oh, so my bad, my bad.
He's a really good player.
So yeah, Star Melon is... officially is the first Indian in Rocket League India to reach Champion 2.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Anudeep might have reached that. It might be a close contest, but yeah. Star Melon has also obtained his champion reward for the season. He has been grinding it out, and I'm hoping that will show in the games that we're going to see.
Yeah, this game's going to be good because both the teams are really high ranked. And LK and Hagun has been playing for a while. Like, they have been a part of Blackout since this, like, the beginning of the Blackout. So they know each other pretty well. And as you have said, they were having like really good rotation the last time you played them. So I'm really looking forward to it. Hebar and Kerwin also, like, I've seen them play a lot together. So they also have a pretty good chemistry with each other. Let's see. I really have really high hopes from this game. This entire series, let's see what I'm out of it.
Yeah, I need to change the overlay. Give me a second. So, sorry about this, guys. Sorry that you have to see it. I'm a bit of a noob streamer. So, who's in blue? I'm a bit confused.
I pulled my bear in blue and Blackout's orange.
Okay, cool. Thank you. Thank God I'm not alone today. Dish is here to help me out. Okay. Indian quality here, guys. You're seeing everything happen right in front of your eyes. And I'll now just go back to the title screen. I think Shankar will be like cursing me under his breath. That's not how you do it.
Shankar wants my address. I don't know why.
Okay, I timed out this. I think I've timed out. Anish, can you just convey to Ace that I've timed out?
Okay.
Am I like not in the lobby?
No, you're not in the lobby.
Okay, I'll just join.
Just join the private match.
Yeah. So we'll be having a game in Farmstead again. Yeah. Interesting.
Okay, anyway, leave the match because they don't own Farmstead.
Yeah, it makes sense. Even though it's a beautiful map, there is some, yeah. I think with every map, like with Aquadome and with, even with Starbase Arc, there has been several like FPS issues, which Cyanix has to hotfix.
Yeah, so they're there in like this Farmstead. I experienced some of them, like sudden frame drops are there. I don't know. From what I've heard, these maps are pretty much optimized on PS4.
Oh, is it?
They're not that good on. Yeah, like. And there's some even differences in the maps. Like, if you go for Coliseum, there's some like architecture thingy which is not in like a PC version, but it is there in PS4. And Aquadome is pretty like much more optimized in PS4 rather than this a PC.
At least I mean, at least Cyanix is doing something for the console people. Sometimes it feels like it's almost all the new perks go to PC.
They started on console. Like, today is the 9-year anniversary for like Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Car Battle Cars.
Oh, yes. Yeah, I do remember.
They turned 9 today. We like include Rocket League in that series as well. So, yeah. They started with consoles, so they have to be like dedicated to them, I think.
Yeah, man. I wonder who the genius was who named them games Supersonic Acrobatic Rocket Power Battle Cars. And then like, okay, no, it's fine. We'll just call it Sam BC. Yeah. At least, and for Indians, it's like Sarp, BC, and oh my god. Okay. So, what do you think of the autumn update? What about the autumn update? I don't remember much. They standardized pushed the maps, doing a soft reset also in the process, but I think they broke up the rank system. At least in my opinion, it's made it easier in Asia to queue. But there is, I still think that the actual skill level is not being represented by the ranks right now. And I'm thinking that there might be a hot fix to that. But there are quite a few issues. I've seen some issues with the boost sound. It sort of glitches out when you feather.
Yeah. And you think like you are not boosting at all. So it messes up with your game a lot.
I'm not completely sure. Like, hopefully, I think what Psyonix generally does is they're like, we need to stick to the schedule. Maybe we've not tested enough. Let's just make everyone else test it for us. Because I remember, like, when the first game starts, right? Like, when the update comes out, the first major Reddit post to get the most upvotes is like that. The bug hunt thread. Nish, by any chance, do you have any cross network enabled Aces?
No. I just checked it.
Okay, let me check. Do I not have cross network? Yeah, mine's okay. It's, sorry guys for making you wait. Arjun is having some issues being from PS5, he's not able to join the server. So it's most likely someone else.
Yeah, the moderator will figure it out. Ace will figure it out. Okay, I think he's searching the server right now. So we'll soon get into the game.
Yeah, so how are you guys? Are you guys looking forward to the Diwali holidays? What are your plans? How many of you are going home? How many of you are home already? Oh my god. The mystery. Okay, so the PC. Oh my god.
So we're finally into the lobby, probably waiting for the players to join in. I hope they join it this time. No issues.
Yeah, I'm hoping so too. Ace is doing a brilliant job so far. Dizzo
is, who's Bolinath?
Bolinath is Alniki. So yeah, okay. Harkun is able to join. So we are nearly ready. We're just getting the teams joining in. So Nish, what are your plans for Diwali?
not sure yet.
Not sure yet. Actually, I mean, celebrating Diwali should be the main major plan.
Actually, the thing is, it's happening on Thursday, if I'm not wrong. Thursday, Friday, okay?
Okay.
And Saturday, Sunday are like off as usual. Mm-hmm. So Monday, like these are the 4 days I have off. So I don't have a large span of holiday or something to do something extravagant.
Okay.
And I have like lots of assignments to do, so
I'm so glad I'm out of college.
I'm quite looking forward to the holidays because that will give me some time to like relax, because like it starts from early in the morning at 8:30, 9:30 and goes till like 5:30 and I reach home at 7:30, so tiring some days.
And after that
I really
like
look forward to those Saturdays and Sundays.
Hopefully we'll get some Rocket League India stuff also happening during that weekend, maybe. I don't know.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're still waiting on the other team to join.
Yeah, Blackout, the whole team is here from the Blackout. We're waiting for Hold My Bear to join it.
So for me, I've already...
One of the issues I've seen with...
Sorry, my bad.
One of the issues I've seen... Yeah, no problem. The other issue I've seen this like with the autumn update is like sometimes when I'm in a game, okay, and like another player, like especially in casual, if a player leaves the game, okay, and some other players joined in. So the player who joined in later on mm-hmm. and in my team will have the same profile picture as me. And that's an issue.
Oh, like, yeah. I've seen that profile picture glitch. I mean, it doesn't load in. It takes like 2-3 goals for everyone's profile picture to load in. Or at least, I mean, using goal as a time. Yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah, so that's a glitch. I think they'll figure it out at it somehow.
Hopefully. Cyanix has been quite responsive to the community. But they are pumping a lot of content. I think the Fast and the Furious new DLC is coming out. That also looks pretty cool.
Yeah, they're coming tomorrow. So. Today is what? Yeah.
Today is the 10th.
So they're coming out tomorrow.
Okay.
And those cars look pretty good.
Yes, I think it's only one. Okay, it's two cars, right?
Two cars.
I forgot the names, man. I'm blanking out here.
I know one is from Nissan.
Okay.
And I don't know the actual name. Star Miller is, okay, so the other team joined in as well. First killer is Heba.
Okay, so...
And Star Miller.
Oh my god, I again disconnected. I keep disconnecting.
Yeah.
Has the game started?
No. Okay, you are in? Okay. We can have the teams in, I think. And we can start.
Yep. We are... ready to start.
So yeah. The team's getting in. Yeah.
Oh my god, what happened? COVID. Come on, people, join in for heaven's sake. We've waited in enough. COVID's doing the job.
Something happening. Yeah.
No. COVID's trying to prevent it from the timer from starting. Come on, guys. Just join in already.
Kevin's trying his best to avoid it, and now they're all trying it.
I'm really what confused. Who are we waiting for?
Are they? I think we're waiting for Star Millen and. Yeah, Star Millen first killer.
Oh my god. I'm just. I don't know what to do now. I'm just keeping it in tab and watching this magic happen right before my eyes. Nish, you're having some issues, I think. First killer is here, Starmalin is trying to join in. Yeah man, this is just Indian issues. Wow. Just Indian things. I think you're having some issues again, Nish. So just try reconnecting if you can. Otherwise, I guess it's a solo cast for me. Yeah, Ace, you gotta remake the solo. Sorry, guys, for making you guys wait. I mean, sometimes it's just like so often that it happens that we have sort of gotten used to it. And Cyanix still is quite unresponsive in making servers in India. Or at least improving the server quality in Asia. Oh well, anyway. So what else is up? I see a few familiar faces. Sir Dizelot, Shashank, Misty. What's up, guys? Misty, do you celebrate Diwali? Okay, we are nearly getting into the lobby. You want me to leave? Okay.
Is it all good now?
Yeah, it's better now. People are joining into the server, yes. So I think that we can use the same server. Can you join the party match? Dies a lot. I think that's what I'm also going to be doing. So playing RL, yeah, that's life. Oh no, okay, Misty. It's a bad server, apparently. Oh, it's a bad server? Okay, let's leave then.
Yeah.
Ace, you need to inform the players. By the way, is the game hanging for you? Like, it's hanging for me. Like, I'm getting kicked. Yeah, the
game. Something's wrong with it today.
I'm getting kicked out of the server quite often.
I don't know.
Sad life, man. Can't even have a scrims without all these issues. So yeah, we actually have another community event lined up this week. Our 2v2 showdown series, right? I think it's fully managed by Nish this time. Thanks a lot. And yeah, it's a sort of first come first serve 16 team based 2v2 double elimination bracket. Man, that was a mouthful. And yeah, it's sort of like about 120 rupees to enter, and the winner gets about, I mean, it's totally about 1800 rupees prize pool. So I'm hoping like people participate. We are trying to develop the 2v2 scene also in India for a possible LAN event. So nothing confirmed, but yeah, it's been a while since we've had a 2v2 tournament.
We have certain insights that it could be a better scene.
Yeah.
You never know. So yeah, if you're Indian and if you're here for the first time, do check out our Discord. And we are having this tournament this week only, like Saturday and Sunday. So do participate in that. Because we only have like 16 slots. So it's better if you like get in a spot before anyone else can get in. Because almost more than half of the spots are filled. So you better make it quick.
Yeah, so I think we have our teams in, if I'm not right. We are missing first killer. Still waiting on him to start. And so right now the people who are actually already joined, like who have already enrolled themselves, you see the family face like Killer, Chaos.
Guacamole is there.
Guacamole, Assyria Titan. A lot of familiar faces. I think a lot of them have been wanting this tournament to happen. Galactus also, but he's not yet registered. I'm hoping he does. So he personally messaged me asking what the scene was. So I'm glad that this is happening.
And we are also getting a feedback for 1v1s. People want 1v1s as well. So if you're interested, we might think of them in the near future.
Yep. Okay, first killer also there, like, joined in.
So I think we can start.
We can start as soon as everyone's ready. So it's all down to Ace right now.
I hope it's not a bad server again.
I don't know.
Pink seems good.
Yep. No issues this time. Starmelon on his signature Batmobile. Oh, we're taking the kick off against Alnicky. So Bolenath is Alnicky, just FYI. Argun also rocking the Batmobile. Centrate for Dizzard. Dizzard following it up. Carmelo. Sorry, continue.
Kerwin making the ball into the corner of the orange half, and Dizzard is there to extend it back towards the goal, and it's a shot on the goal, and Dizzard scores. And that was a really, really good clear from Dezo right there. And he just converted into a really good goal as well.
Yeah, got a lot of power behind that ball. Couldn't really... I think first killer was not appropriately positioned to make that save.
Yeah, they screwed the rotation. And that was the reason that nobody was back to save that goal. Kerwin centered to the first killer. Starmelon going for it in the air. Dezo unable to get a 50-50 with him. First killer gets a 50-50 with Bolenath, and Bolenath is Alnicky, right?
Yeah, Bolenath is Alnicky.
I'll say Alnicky rather than Bolenath. So Hagun going for the clears there. He gets it out, but Starmelon sends it back into the orange half. Minya trying to get a double turn, that was close. Alnicky getting the possession of the ball. Centering it, but Kerwin is there to clear it out.
Dizzo with a crucial midfield presence. Stamil and Mui down to the side, trying to find his teammate. He's covering in position, waiting for the center. Stamil ends up pinching it against the backward wall. Irwin takes the shot, misses. Okay, awkward contest by first killer. Wulinath picker to the ball, ends up centering it to the first team. Dizzo missing out on it. Stamina with a shot opportunity. First killer, can he? No, he can't. Irwin trying to center it. Again, Dizzo with a clear, searching for Hargun, who centers it for his teammate. A bit too far.
I don't know what first killer did there. He almost centered the ball for the orange team to score on. But somehow he got away with it. And now Hargun's trying to center the ball, but Kervin's there to clear it off. And orange team is maintaining a pressure on the blue half. And Dizzo with another sort of opportunity, but Kervin again saves it. And with now that going really close.
Stamelin was busy checking if there was anyone behind, but just couldn't convert that opportunity.
Stamelin going, taking the ball with him, and he's going for that shots from the corner, trying to center it for himself only, and that's a good pass from Kervin, and Stamelin was unable to convert it into a goal.
Oh God.
Blue team is pressuring the orange team so hard right now. Kervin again with the center, but Hargun is there to clear it off from the side. And first killer, shot on the goal, Dizzo there to save it. Wow, that's a really, really weird 50-50 right there. If would have been gotten a little more power, it would have been goal definitely. Hargun somehow getting a touch there.
I was finding it really hard to concentrate. So now I put it back in director mode. So Dizzo moving to the side. Killer not able to touch it. Leaving it for Kervin, who dangerously centers it for Stamil. Orange taking a breather. Hargun moving it down the side. But he actually gives a possession to Killer, who's trying to center it for Blue. Is anyone there to follow it? Kervin missing. Stamil centering it for his team. Alniki searching for a teammate, but no one there to follow it up. Killer first to the ball.
Stamelin again sending the ball to the corner. I think he really likes those corners. He's always getting shots from there, taking the ball into the corner and centering it for himself or either his teammate. And that's a really nice a tactic, I would say, because sometimes it's hard to judge. And Stamelin with a shot on the goal.
Yeah, Hargun misplayed that, trying to slow it down, but ends up centering it for blue team, and Stamelin just popping it down into the corner. The scores are now tied 1-1 with 48 seconds left.
We might have an overtime in this game as well. Dizzo wins the 50-50. Hargun misses it. And Elniki demoing first killer there.
Kervin
going backwards.
Yeah. I don't know. He was trying something awkward there. But it all worked out in the end. Dizzo moving to the corner. Kervin there to contest. Centering for Killer, who ends up passing it back, passing it to Hargun. Chama with the shot, with the save. Trying to follow it up. Interesting. Continue.
Interesting play by Dizzo. He decided to stay on ground rather than going for a 50-50 there, because that would have been dangerous. So really smart play from Dizzo there. And that was a short opportunity, but they missed.
The ball still not down yet. Hargun.
Yeah.
He has some mad 1v1 skills, but ends up dropping the ball.
Yeah.
Stamil are winning that 50-50. Kervin up in the air, hits the ceiling, not able to really give it to his teammate. Hargun dangerously centering it with a shot. Killer moving to the side. Killer again searching for Stamil. Stamil gets demolished in the process. Kervin has some time faking out Orange. Shot opportunity by Alniki. Can he follow it up? Nice touch.
Nice, nice touch. Really nice touch by Elneny there. And that result in a goal right there.
Beautiful backward play, to be honest. He was able to read that right after it came up. And yeah, it was really nice.
So with that, Blackout wins the first match. And it's going to be pretty exciting. Like, you can see, like, the players are everywhere. They almost have the same scores, so they're doing a really good job at every position. And they're playing, like, giving all of their in the game.
Yeah, so actually, good to see. Blackout has, I mean, an overall, like, 3-2-2, nice shots across the range.
Yeah.
But Kerwin's just showing that he's the team player. Even though with zero shots, he has the saves and the clears to actually get the score.
Yeah. So moving on to the game two now.
Oh, I forgot to update the scores. okay, Blackout won, right?
It's fine, you're doing too much already.
Tell me about it.
The casting. Yeah. Casting and streaming is like really difficult to do.
Yep. At least I have some. Oh my god, that was dangerous. Okay.
Oh, that was almost an own goal.
Kerwin searching for Starmalin. Starmalin could have bumped someone in the process, but Killer not able to follow it. Kerwin, close one. Hargun moving it across. Starmalin with a good deft touch in the middle.
Elneny a shot on a goal, but first player was there to save it. And Dezo is. He tries to make it a shot, but it goes into the corner. And Kerwin passing to first killer, that's a really good passing play by him, but Kerwin missed on the last pass. Hargun sent it onto the blue half.
Oh!
And he gets a shot. Oh, that was so close. And Kerwin is there to save another shot from Elneny. And Kerwin dribbling it.
I'm a bit confused with that choice over there. He slowed the ball down when he was up, but he lost possession in the process. And again, the pressure's in orange. Pressure's with orange now. Elneny missing it out, trying to find another orange player, but gives away possession, arguing with a crucial touch, but still gives it away to Elneny.
Dezo is trying to get that ball, but he misses, and Hargun with a 50-50, it goes into the orange half again. Elneny is there on the wall to send it on to the blue half, and like you can see the ball is moving just back and forth between the teams, and they are having like short opportunities, but they're defending it pretty well. Both the teams are doing a really great job at the defense right now, and they're still creating. Like, if you see, both the team, like, Blackout right now has 3 shots on goal. Hold 1 shot on goal. So, I would say Hold My Beer, like, really good with the defense. They're stopping the shots incoming from the Blackout.
Oh, and first killer. They're
trying a passing player. This passing player was really good. Kerwin to first killer there, and then back to Kerwin.
Yeah, 1-2-1.
right into the goal.
Kerwin and first killer have been sort of like playing a lot together, so it's only expected. Kerwin missing that shot, Elneny following it up instead. Not able to find a teammate, killer clearing it away. Starmalin searching for killer. Oh, Starmalin leaves. Killer leaves it to Starmalin, but Dezo is quicker to the ball. Oh, an awkward touch. Oh, and that to save it. Starmalin. Okay. Wow, that was a calculated save. Anish, you're disconnecting again.
My bad.
okay. You're back. So Starmalin with a nice shot, a bit of a whiffed save by Hargun. Kerwin against Dezo, Kerwin winning.
50-50, Hargun. I don't know what Hargun was trying there. He sent the ball back into his own half.
Oh, and this Sam is a really good touch. Player. This is showing good presence. Okay, Kerwin, back into the center.
Yeah,
that was a bit of a weird touch. Dizzo had that presence, but Al-Nikki tried to follow it up, sort of missed out on that rotation, and Kerwin just had all the time and space to make that shot happen.
Actually, if you see off the screen, Hagun was trying to get back to the goal, but in the process, he bumped Dizzo and he was like unable to get back into the goal, and that's why he scored. The blue team scored. So, pass to Dizzo, Dizzo to Al-Nikki, but he missed.
Yeah, Stammen
gets the clear. And Dizzo is back. Like, he's staying a lot back and he's doing a really good job defending the goal. First killer, trying to get a shot, but got a really soft touch on it. Dizzo trying to make it to the blue half. And wow, the mid-air demo by first killer on Hagun. The demos are really crazy recently.
Yeah, the bumping and the mechanics has completely changed. Kerwin searching for Stamina
is a really nice drop, but he couldn't like put it on the goal. First killer centering the ball. He pulls out two defenders from orange team, but that was really good clear. Dizzo trying to figure out something to do, send the back ball into the own half. The ball, Kerwin drops it. And they're trying so hard to score right now. You can see the panic in the orange half of the team. They're trying out like whatever they can, innovative plays to score a goal. And Dizzo gets the opportunity and he scores right away.
Yeah, a bit of over-rotation from Blue, Kerwin missing out on that, and Stamlin just not in the position to make that read.
Yeah, that's just because they have the lead and they're like, okay, we can take one goal if it goes bad. So they're all there pressurizing the orange team to get a goal for themselves. But it just like worked opposite to them, instead orange team got a goal on them. Yeah, but they can afford it right now.
Oh no, they can't.
now it's getting close. They are way too casual with this thing. Kerwin tried to save it but was unable to do it.
And I mean, I'm not taking anything away from Hagman. That was a really good follow through from his wall touch. It's just a bad play from Kerwin, but a great play from Hagman.
Yeah. Starman into first killer. But it was a weird 50-50. A first killer trying to make it ball to the orange half. Stamina comes in from behind, bumps first killer in the process. Al-Nikki, that could have been a goal, but here we are. End of the game and Holman Bjørgens.
So that levels the series, right?
Yeah, it's 1-1.
That is my
so
life.
So if you see...
Sorry.
So if you see like Blackout has more number of shots, so and the defend from like a defensive play from Hold My Beer was really good. Kerwin had two saves, first killer had three. So they have to figure out holes in their defense if Blackout want to win, because I've been noticing Hold My Beer has really good defense. And it's shown in the numbers as well.
Yeah,
so I think
the way that Blackout, the way I see Blackout doing it is actually being more precise with your shots. A good amount of shots really means that you are having your rotation correct. And Holmabier is showing that, saves are there, but it's not great if you have more saves than shots. It indicates
actually, they are trying to like keep one pair always in there on the defensive side. So that might be the reason they're getting less goal, like shots on goal, but it doesn't matter if you score them, even if you're getting two.
Right.
So that's what I think their strategy is right now. So I think the orange team has to figure it out. The Blackout has to figure it out and find holes in that to move ahead with it.
Yeah, I assume that they can, because it was still a close game, 3-2.
Yeah,
the series is still leveled. Salman with the shot opportunity. Critical touch from Orange to save that. Salman trying to center it, falling it up. No, messes up that jump. Awkward in the corner. Aliki saving a good and his team in the process. But Killer down the center again, giving him the possession, but pressurizing still. Aliki with a great clear down the corner.
Aliki following it as well, but it goes into the other corner across the goal. Hagun misses it, and first Killer gets a shot on that. Dizzo getting a shot on goal, but Kervin is there to save it. And he gets a really good clear with that.
Yeah, Hargun just waiting on that ball for that, being the last man back. Made the touch happen. Dizzo moving down the side, has no time, taking it slow. Misses that dribble touch. Killer having some time now. Trying to find a teammate in the process, misses the flip. Dizzo waiting for his teammate to clear it instead. No, Dizzo's taking the ball possession instead. Kervin, can he make the double touch happen now? Aliki, Starmelin searching for his teammate. Hargun is quicker to the ball, but Kervin's there to pressurize it.
And that's going in center. Okay, that was really close, but a good save from Hargun coming in. And Aliki sending to Dizzo. Dizzo did not get enough power to like get the ball in the goal. He thought he'll get a better shot, but he got an awkward touch and could not get that power. And right now, Orange is trying really hard to not get things scored on, but Blue is really pushing. Really good touch from Dizzo there. It would have been a goal.
Oh, beautiful play.
Beautiful
counter-attack. Stammer taking it slow, searching for his teammate, finds Kervin in the process, who gets under the ball, gets enough power, 120 kilometers per hour, that's almost close to a pinch shot.
Yeah.
So kickoff going towards Orange, Hargun awkwardly trying to play it into Blue's half, but Kervin there. Dizzo contesting in midfield, Starmelin clearing down the side. Bolinar, can he make the play? Yes, he ball clears it. Killer backboard touch. Starmelin back into the backboard, searching for Kervin, who makes the touch happen, but Aliki is there to save it.
Yeah, actually, Starmelin waited there, and the Orange team had the advantage of like, see, wow, that's a really good save from Dizzo.
He's
aware of the thing, and that would have been a goal if he wouldn't have been gone for that. And they're pushing it, the Blue team. Kervin bumps Starmelin in the process, and first Killer moving forward with the ball. Starmelin comes in, Aliki gets shot on backboard, and that's a goal. So there, I don't know what happened there. See, right here, if you see, the there was a double commit from the Blue team.
Yeah, but
they both went for the
Aliki also played that smart. He read that and then hit the backboard, drawing a curve and also in the process.
Yeah.
Orange going for
his best to get the touch.
Messes it up in the process. Hargun, can he follow it up? No. Killer earlier to the ball, centers it. No, it's a shot on goal. So, centering it for Blue again. Stamelin pushing it to the corner, but it pops out right for Orange player to clear. A beautiful Aliki, midfield contest. Yeah, sorry. My bad.
Hargun there trying to get the ball. He like somehow get it away from Stamelin. Now in the Blue half, he misses it, and first Killer also misses touch, and then Aliki misses as well. And now Kervin has the possession of the ball right now. He's going for it, but Hargun is back there. Now the Blackout is also keeping a player back in the defensive position, so they're trying to avoid those goals that happened in the first game.
sorry, in the second game. And Hagun, I don't know what, he got into awkward position and tried to get it backwards. Dezo gets a, wins a 50-50. Eilnicki with a great shot, and that was a pinch.
Yeah, Dezo, good contest in midfield, pops it up for a teammate, pops it up for himself rather, because his teammate ended up making.
Yeah, that was not a pinch. I thought that Eilnicki shot it, but it was Dezo only.
First killer
winning the kickoff.
I think we need to sort this out. But okay, it's fine. Hargun with the shot opportunity, going for the bounce shot. Can't be read by Blue defense. He didn't have enough boost to make that double jump.
So that was a really nice play there. Like, putting it down and getting a bounce shot. He could have shot it directly on the goal, but the defender might have saved it. So he went for a bounce shot and got the goal.
Dezo, taking it slow, but Stamulen punishes him for that. Dezo again moving into the side. They are two goals up, and I think it's a comfortable win for Orange now.
Yeah, they just gonna waste the time now. Or just put the ball down on the ground. But they're still keeping it up.
Okay, this actually shows the strength of Blackout as a roster, despite having mechanically amazing players like Irvin and Stamelen. Good rotation, good shot making from Blackout, really sealing the deal for them.
So it really pans out for them this match, because keeping that one person back in the defensive position, you can see the number of saves have increased for them. So, yeah. I think they figured out, like, they have to keep a player back. They were, going out of rotation in the second match, but they're working on it. So, let's see. This will result in even much more better game four now.
Your voice is having that familiar robotic tinge to it.
Yeah, I have a filter on somehow.
So, yeah, 1-2 towards Blackout.
Yeah, and we're going in game 4. And if Blackout wins this, it's like the end of the series.
Yeah, I'd assume that, you know, Holmebier can actually come back, because they do need to just take the game seriously and stop searching for each other, making the shots happen. They tend to make mistakes when they are, but they are ending up making mistakes in the process. But that's the purpose of scrims in the end, to actually make those plays happen. Kerwin touching into the center, searching for a teammate. Stamulen going to contest, but misses out. Eilnicki moving into the side. Not enough boost to follow through. First killer with enough time to clear it away. Dezo searching for his teammate. No one there. Stamulen misses that open shot. He will try centering it for his teammate. Dezo contesting it early, making the shot awkward for Blue, but Kerwin there to save it. Sorry, pass it. And Dezo again clearing it away. Dezo's multitasking for his team on the backboard, on the corner. It's a really good sign of skill.
Yeah. And ball seems sending it right into the blue half. But there was no one to, like, they were out of rotation for a while there, but blue team taking it slow made them come back into the rotation. Dezo was, like, really doing, he's everywhere. He's in the defensive position, he's there in the offense and everything. And Hagun tried to do something special there, but that would have been a goal if Hargan was not there to interfere it.
Beautiful save by Hargan. Yeah, Hargan continuing the ball, flicks it to himself, centers it for his team, but no one there to follow. Killer missing the clear. Dezo centering back for Orange, but Eilnicki pre-jumping misses out on it completely. Hargan, good 50-50, realized that Kerwin was going to be first the ball. Nice clear from Dezo down the side. Oh, beautiful contest. Yeah, a really good 50-50. Realized that he can make it in time and had the height onto the ball. Just ends up outpacing the blue defense.
And Dezo's a player, like, he's not afraid of getting these shots. he'll never back away from these kind of shots. He'll go for that 50-50. He'll make that happen. So that is rewarding most of the time, but it can be punishing as well.
Yeah, Kerber with a beautiful 50-50 draws out two defenders, but Starmer is not able to convert on that opportunity. First killer awkwardly trying to get back into goal, half flips, is able to make that save. Dizzo sentry dangerously again. Good presence of mind, but no one there to follow. Double coming from Blue, dangerously in the center. Alnicki following it up. Pressure completely in from Orange side. Argun searching for a teammate. Yeah. A lot of pressure coming in from Orange.
Yeah. Also, they know if they lose this, the series.
Oh my god. Beautiful, beautiful conversion of pressure. All three of them boosted. Dizzo realized, yes, that's the time to actually make the shot happen. Aims a far corner. And good accuracy.
Yeah, that's a really good shot with that angle and everything.
Oh, dangerous. What?
He left the match? What happened there? Elnicki gets it straight. First killer moves out of the way. Kerwin does not stop it. Back flips. I'm not sure what happened there.
I am completely dumbfounded. It's...
That literally rendered me speechless. Like...
Yeah.
I don't know what is happening. Oh, Kerwin is back in the game.
Okay, that is really Orange hilarious.
Team, yeah. Orange team letting, I think Orange team letting them score one or late. Kerwin not being there. He made a disconnected.
Probably. Maybe his controller just decided to give up on him.
And about that, Argun just scores a goal right off the top.
Yeah, it's like Kerwin didn't leave. It's just back to the same goal difference.
And whatever the exciting matches we were having up till now, it just like turned into something really weird and different.
Yeah, I think Kerwin's having some issues probably. I'm not sure if he's a controller player. I think he's keyboard mouse, so that also wouldn't make sense. We might be having some internet issues.
Yeah.
Killer moving down the side. Let's just continue casting until Kerwin's back. Stamil and contesting it in the middle. Popping it up for himself. Argun with the contest. Searching for the corner. Trying to center it for his team. Centers it for himself instead. Finds his teammate. Yep. Bolin are able to.
Score it. Yeah.
Yeah. He tried to score it, yeah.
But that's a good play. Yeah, I'm also thinking we kind of gave up. I don't know, Irvin is there, but I'm not seeing him play. Yeah, so let's see what happens. We can still come back from this. Dizzo with trying to clear it, but it again, it's put him in a weird position. And Licky. Kerwin is like really, I don't know, he's avoiding touching the ball somehow.
I'm not sure. I think he's just waiting for the timer to count down. Probably a bit frustrated that they're losing. But it's a season side. I mean, Blackheart has been showing promise, and it's great that the script is giving them a shot to play against some veteran players like Starmer and Kerwin and come out on top.
And Kerwin is standing there, not bothering to play at all, while his team is trying really hard to get something on the scoreboard.
Yeah, Orange team don't really care. They are trying to make the play still happen because it's an opportunity. Double comment from Orange. Dizzo dangerously centering for Blue. If Blue was playing seriously, that was a goal opportunity. Stamina popping it for himself, arguing with a really good contest. Someone misses the defensive clear. And yeah, with 7 seconds down, I think after the third goal, Kerwin just gave up and Blue couldn't come back.
Yeah.
That's a consolatory goal, Kerwin with the rage.
Yeah, I think the Orange team literally, you can see
all the three always play bumped into each other and they just gave them a goal for free.
Yeah, and Blackout wins it. Yeah.
Wins it. 3-1, if I'm not wrong.
Yep, 3-1.
And Kevin, I rage quit or something. I don't know. He just left it.
Yeah, let's assume the worst. Like, probably he was having internet issues.
Yeah. Maybe he was going to save that goal and his controller disconnected or something, and then he was like tilted and he don't want to play anymore or something like that. I don't know. It happens sometimes.
Yeah. GG's to Blackout. Great games. Good overall rotation and accuracy in shots from Blackout. And yeah, that's the purpose of these scrims, to actually give a chance for everyone to participate. Nothing much, I guess, left. So we had two best of fives. The first one went to, I can't recall the, is it Diamond Dust?
It was Diamond Dust.
Yeah.
And not the time. And yeah. Diamond Dust won.
Yeah, Diamond Dust ended up winning despite the multiple issues in internet.
Yeah.
But yeah, a good series altogether.
Yeah.
So yeah, just another reminder. We have the 2v2 cup coming up this weekend. If you're Indian and if you love Rocket League India, please do participate. We are looking for 16 slots. It is a pay to play tournament, but everything goes towards the prize pool, fully organized by Rocket League India for the community.
Also, you can donate in the prize pool as well if you want. Like, if you don't want to play, you just want to donate, you can do that as well. Apart from that, we are having October on Twitch, so if you want to subscribe, it's on like 50% discount. So the $4.99 sub, you can get it for $2.50, if I'm not wrong. So if you can subscribe, do that. That's all going in these tournaments that we're going to organize in the near future. So that's really helping from the community, and we're always looking forward to like to help us.
Yeah, Nish, your voice is back to its normal self. So yeah, nothing else. Do check out our Facebook page, our Facebook group, as well as our Discord, which are the most active areas where you can find Indians playing Rocket League. And yeah, and other Asians as well who have started joining in. Do tune in to our Twitch stream, follow it if you haven't already, and subscribe if you want to show us some support.
Yeah, also we are having this thing, we're looking for some staff like casters, editors, streamer. So if you're interested in that as well, do check out our website. We have all the links there. And
My god, so, your internet though. Anyway, this is me signing off, Guacamole, and
yeah, bro, I'm signing off as well.
That's so. Nish, since he's not saying his name. Yeah, thanks for joining in. Hope you enjoyed the stream.
Yeah.